Culture of the NBA now involves using your platform to speak out for good. That's part of what it means now to play in the NBA. When Craig Hodges was playing, it obviously wasn't. He was one of the very few that saw the platform they had and wanted to use it in this space. You know, his voice wasn't heard in the moment. He planted the seed that has caught on. His legacy will forever be that he was one of the players that started guys speaking up and using their voice and understanding that we have a platform and that we have to take advantage of it. Privilege is one of these words that just throws people. We stereotype a lot of white people who act a certain way, have certain prejudices, but I can't pass judgment. You don't know what you don't know. As white people, we don't want to show where we've missed. But part of this whole thing shifting is us owning our own stories. That takes hard conversations. And that's where we have to be. Those are the conversations that we have to have. I believe in the good of people, and I want to call on the good in each of us to take that step forward. Race is tied to virtually every single issue, every hot topic in our country. You have to be able to dig into this. You have to be able to hear it. And so it's important to have an open mind and an open heart.
Welcomes you to the following presentation of the NBA.
As they came through the tunnel earlier, the Pacers were already in all business mode, ready to defend their home floor. The tallest building in the state of Indiana, the Chase Tower, rising high above our location today at Bankers Life Fieldhouse in Indianapolis. Welcome, everyone. Thanks for tuning in to 2K Sports. We've got some NBA action for you coming up. Kevin Harlan here with Greg Anthony and Clark Kellogg, and we'll have David Aldridge filling us in from the sideline. DA, it's all yours.
Kevin, thank you very much. We all know Anthony Edwards went first overall in 2020, and his teammate Karl-Anthony Towns said, "I know what all those pressures are like. When you're the number one pick, if any other rookies do well, there's a threat to the throne." But with Edwards' confidence and his talent, you get the sense he'll be just fine. Guys?
Good point. No pressure, DA. Thank you. And we've got a quick moment now to take a look at the long-term rebounding numbers over several seasons for Tristan Thompson.
It's a concerning trend for him. Whether he's lost some strength or just isn't putting in as much effort on the glass as he used to, he's not rebounding nearly as effectively anymore. And that's something that needs to change.
And the starting lineup for the Timberwolves. They've got Towns. Russell is out there with Patrick Beverley. Then there's Edwards. And it's Vanderbilt in a power forward. And for the Pacers, they've got Tyrese Halliburton. And it's Brissett in at the four spot. For the teams that are clearly rebuilding, Greg, should they simply play the young guns no matter what, or should they make them earn their minutes?
I think there should be a combination. And as long as guys are pros and really approaching the game the right way, you want to give them an opportunity to grow, and also it gives you a chance to evaluate.
And he comes up with the deuce.
You like what you have there. Russell, crafty with the dribble.
Halliburton against Russell. And D'Angelo Russell picks up the foul. That's his first foul.
And that's a quick foul for him there. Looks like the refs are going to call this one pretty close.
To the paint. Here's Halliburton. Beautiful dish, and the layup goes down.
And once he got to the 10, I think he was surprised to find himself that wide open.
Well, this early, they should be showing a lot more energy on defense. It's not there.
And offensive mastery right there. I mean, great move in the lane and then the flush.
But just no way for the D to handle it.
Well, I tell you what, you just got to sit back and admire the creativity there.
Here's Bitadze following the bucket by the Timberwolves. Sinks the triple.
And they don't want to get in a habit of giving him open looks from three. First quarter still, but not who you want to leave open.
And that one's good. Russell.
They opened the gates, and he came through. D'Angelo, quick recognition.
It's tipped. Pass to Brissett. Some nice passing here by Indiana. Inside. Plays it up and banks it in.
Sensational ball movement there. When you pass the ball like that, good things happen.
Timberwolves have gotten their first three shots to go in for him to start off this game. Here's Beverly, and he jams it with authority.
And, you know, Beverly has great speed. Snake-like in how he slips through the defense on the drive.
And there's the pass to Towns. Goes up, and the dunk by Towns.
Great teamwork, punctuated by a strong finish.
That is the perfect fast break, guys. Getting a hoop before the defense can get set.
And so it's Halliburton who brings up the ball for the Indiana Pacers. It's a three-point game to the inside. Duarte, that falls. Nice feed that time from Halliburton. Duarte has got five.
And this is how you want to start the ball game. 4 for 4 from the field. Seems like they're right on point and can't miss.
The shot's good from Vanderbilt.
Well, I love the way he goes after it there. I mean, and you've got to respect that. He's rewarded for his efforts of pursuing the ball.
And there's the foul. It's on Brissett. That's his first foul.
And really, these are some of the toughest calls an official has to make.
Yeah, but in this case, I think he got it right. I mean, the defender was still moving there and never really had good legal guarding position. He wasn't set.
Now, here's Beverly. Taking a look at the scoring numbers. Right now, he averages about 9 points a game. And Russell gets it to go.
And their offense already in a flow. Some stellar shooting to jump out to this league.
Quality looks they're getting, and they're capitalizing on them, guys. They have to be happy with this start offensively. Man, what a pass that was there. He really, really relishes making the game easier for his teammates.
Nothing soft about the putback there.
And why chance it, right? Take the dunk if you've got it.
Well, you know, if nobody's going to put a body on him, then that's going to be the result.
Ball's knocked loose and stolen by Russell. And the slam dunk by Russell.
Boy, deceptive athleticism that Russell has for a point guard. This young man is sneaky in his ability to get up.
Halliburton passes to Bitadze. Towns with the steal. And here we go. Towns heading to the hoop. Basket is good. He'll get a chance for one more at the line. And guys, what do you think about the hustle stats here for Minnesota?
They've come out in attack mode on the defensive end. They've applied pressure and forcing turnovers.
You know, another factor in their offense so far has been their ability to convert and score off turnovers.
The free throw drops for Towns.
And Towns, not known for his rim protection, but he's improved in that area recently, challenging and changing more shots.
Here's Beverly. Got a piece of it. And we're just over 3.5 minutes into the first quarter. Brissett, no good. Timberwolves leading by 11. And with Towns, Greg, you knew he had the potential for rim defense, and it became a focus for him.
Yeah, and a lot of defense is putting in the effort. Credit Towns for improving in that area. And we'll see if he can take another step defensively.
I mean, with the amount of turnovers they've committed, it's no wonder they're in the position they're in right now.
And that was another look at the aggressive D that led to the Mobile One block.
And making a statement right away, letting them know they won't get any easy ones when he's around.
Edwards drives in, and Edwards with the stuff.
I like their focus coming in. Terrific execution so far.
And, you know, it's an all-out effort they've come in with. Very aggressive offense so far.
Here's Duarte, 5 points in the game. And the whistle blows. It's going to be on Anthony Edwards.
That's his first personal foul.
That's his first foul. Halliburton up top. Will it go? And off the front iron, and in it goes. RJ has got 7 points in the game.
Well, that's one way he can finish, but far from the only way he gets it done. He's got all kinds of tricks up his sleeve. Excellent all-around performance so far, hence the big lead.
Yeah, you know, they've had the advantage at both ends. They've got all the momentum early on.
It's stolen by Edwards. Here's Russell, and the slam dunk by Russell.
Good gamble that time by Edwards. He, as much as anybody, wants this team to be out in the open floor.
Halliburton passes to Bitadze. Here's Duarte driving in over Edwards. Here's Bitadze. Edwards defending. Bitadze can't hit.
Take what's available. Use the fadeaway when the defender's there on it.
And Edwards with the stop.
And they have owned the paint so far, and the score reflects it.
And, you know, establishing that physical dominance early gives you a big mental edge, too. Don't discount that.
And so here is Indiana after the basket by Minnesota. And D'Angelo Russell picks up the foul. That's foul number two for him. The Pacers making a switch here. Heels checked in. They get a hand on it. A three ball. Drills the three-pointer.
From the looks of it, it appears the defense is fine with him taking that shot, but he makes them pay when they do.
So the Timberwolves called their first timeout. Last time they met was in Minnesota.
Yeah, it was a narrow win. But in that last meeting, I think foul trouble for the other side may have really just tipped the scale and allowed them to escape with the W.
You know, whether it was their smart play or a few whistles that perhaps could have gone either way. When games are tight, every decision becomes more magnified.
Fans, your pace makes. Your pace made.
And so it's Russell with it. He'll bring it up for the Minnesota Timberwolves. They lead by 14. It falls for the sixth time in seven tries this contest. That's 86%.
Boy, what a quarter for him. I mean, he's found his rhythm, and he's really riding that wave right now.
Here's Bitadze. No points in the game yet for him. Off target from outside. Timberwolves leading by 16. Russell from long range. And another three for Minnesota.
Guys, absolutely feeling it. When Russell heats up, showtime.
A 11 feet away. Here's Dwarje. He hits the back iron and sinks the shot.
Timberwolves.
RJ has got 9.
Strong start here early. 4 of his first 5 made.
Minnesota calls timeout. Outplayed in the previous game on their schedule, losing to Chicago.
Yeah, I mean, on the road, their defense was just overrun. Couldn't match the intensity of the opponent, and it cost them.
And you know what, guys? It just seemed like they never really had the kind of energy necessary. They just weren't comfortable on the defensive end.
Checked in for the Pacers. Smith comes in for Brissett, and then for Minnesota. Reed comes in for Vanderbilt, and it's Beasley in for D'Angelo Russell. Edwards drives in, and Edwards with the stuff.
Well, I tell you what, once Edwards accelerates, I mean, he looks like he's playing at a different speed than those around him.
Pacers trail by 19. Pass to Thompson. Down low, here's Dwarje, and the layup is good. 11 points in the game.
Great quarter for him at the offensive end, trying to will his team back in the game.
And that one clearly a foul, gets the whistle, and 2 shots coming up.
And you know, Beverly is easily one of the most tenacious defenders in the league, an absolute pest of epic proportion. Love his energy.
The Timberwolves shooting their 2nd and 3rd shots at the line right here.
And their success rate on the season, right around 77%.
The first free throw is good. Both free throws good from Beverly. Pacers trail by 19. Sykes bangs home the trifecta.
And not just a score. Heald is solid at reading when his guys are open for a look.
Takes it inside. And it's Beverly missing.
Oh, you've got to be able to deliver when you get a bunny like that. That's just too easy of a shot to miss.
Tries from 10. Beasley with the rebound.
And the D does just enough to throw off his rhythm on that shot.
And the dunk by Towns.
Towns is especially dangerous when he's cutting to the rim like this. Really good mobility for a big guy.
For the Pacers, they come in off a loss to Cleveland.
Yeah, I mean, they had their chances, competed deep into that game, but had a few lulls there that just kind of took them down.
And, you know, those are the kind of games that sting and that bad taste lingers. Knowing you were in it, but not coming through down the stretch, those are hard to get over sometimes.
And here we go. Fast break. Towns has got it. Stolen by Thompson. Stevenson with it. He's been quiet so far. Still no points in the game. Here's Beasley. Good, and the assist goes to Towns.
Defensively, giving up far too many open rhythm looks.
And to battle back, they've got to shore up the defense. I mean, there's no other way to come back from a deficit unless you play good defense.
Here's Stevenson. Malik Beasley making his last shot. Shot by Heald, nobody around. First shot, first basket. He's out of the blocks fast.
And this is how confident Heald is. Knows he's capable of torching the D off the catch.
He muscles it in through the contact, and they call the foul. He's on his way to the free throw line.
And they're beginning to just flat out fall apart defensively right now, especially on the interior.
Yeah, and that's four straight field goals now they've allowed from point blank range. Can't happen.
And that one falls for Reed.
And one thing about Naz Reed, he knows how to play within himself.
You're absolutely right, Greg. He doesn't force shots. He rarely takes any shot that's contested. That's why his efficiency is so good. Well, I'll tell you what, his vertical is awesome, off the charts. A short center who still makes his presence felt.
Just playing with poise and confidence. Man, they continue to put points on the board.
Boy, I like the way they're playing. A very smart first half. Quality shots, not wasting possessions.
And here's Heald. He'll bring it up for the Pacers. So the Pacers call timeout, their first of the game.
And the lack of rim protection, top of the list.
Yeah, you know, just look at the numbers, guys. I mean, they are being taken to the woodshed in the paint.
Make some noise.
Timberwolves making a change here. Okogie's checked in. And it's the Pacers with the ball. Pope loose. And Edwards with a clear path to the basket. Finish off the break.
Anthony
Edwards got 14.
This is some kind of performance we're seeing from him today. He has yet to miss a shot.
To the middle. Here's Stevenson. And two free throws coming up, unable to get that one to go with all the contact. It's on Anthony Edwards.
When Lance Stevenson is focused, he's very dangerous, has a ton of talent, good, strong physical body, athletic, versatile. He does a lot of good things out there.
It's his first trip to the line.
Shots.
Shooting two.
And the first one drops. He makes one of two that time. And the Timberwolves with possession. They're on a 13-5 run here. And finished off by Edwards.
Oh, doctor. Oh, my goodness. Anthony Edwards throwing it down with force. Get this guy in the dunk contest.
His shot was hindered by that momentous mobile one block.
And, guys, that block could really help change the momentum of this game.
And we're going to have a jump ball. It's tied up there. And so it's Minnesota with it. And Beasley, here we go. Misses from close range. Indiana's gone 3-of-4 on three-pointers in the first quarter. Doing well from long range. Heald with the bucket.
And never shying away from a three. Heald has supreme confidence in his shot.
There's the drive. And that one, good. Beverly's got 8 points.
They're finding lanes to the hoop now with consistency. 5 buckets in a row from the paint.
And on the flip side, the defenders have to show more fight on the interior. They've got to offer more resistance here.
Sykes gets blocked.
How impressive was that? The little fella, Beverly, extending out for the block. Showed us some nice timing for a guy that's not much taller than 6'2". He's certainly been cold this quarter, guys, but trying to shoot his way back into a groove.
Stolen by Beverly, and now Minnesota on the fast break. Here's Beasley. Smith with some nice D.
Boy, just cannot buy a bucket, guys. And tell you what, that's a painful quarter for him, and it's painful for me to watch, too.
Field with the bucket.
Hey, guys, there are some you can give that shot to, but let's be clear, he's not one of them. Terrible job there by the D.
Knocked away. Stolen by Beverly. Here's Okogie. And the powerful one-handed slam.
Assist from.
Yeah, you know, this is just too easy for Okogie. I mean, the defense cannot afford to let him get deep, established positioning.
Now, here is Smith. Passes it to Heal. Front pass the arc. It's hauled in by Beverly. Beverly's got his 4th rebound in this one. 5-second differential between the shot clock and the game clock. Pulls up on the elbow, and it comes off the front of the rim.
You're not going to see that very often. Plenty of space, but he just, let's face it, he whiffs on it.
And it's blocked.
Well, you see the defensive prowess there. I mean, I love when Okogie gets up and sends it back. Not many guys of his size can do that.
We've got 13 seconds left to play here in the first. Now here's Heald. Smith on the wing. Just 3 on the clock. Nice spin off the left rim and in. Smith's got his 2nd bucket. And here's Beverly. D'Angelo Russell getting it done for the Minnesota Timberwolves. What an amazing quarter. There was absolutely no stopping him. We'll get right back to the action when we return. Welcome back to the 2nd quarter of action. Plenty of basketball left to play, but this one has been one-sided so far. And a comfortable margin for the Timberwolves here, guys.
Well, you can see these guys are unafraid to take chances defensively.
Well, you know, the defense, guys, is just disruptive, active, and energetic, and you can't afford to be loose with the ball against these guys.
And, Clark, you know, you were actually one of the original stretch bigs, so do you think your game would be more suited for today's NBA?
Kevin, stretch big may be stretching it a little bit and analyzing my game. I did have a decent shot, but my work was done with ball skills and scoring inside. I would have added the perimeter shot, so I think I would have been able to handle today's game effectively, being kind of a combo forward, big enough to do work inside, but skilled enough to get outside, too.
On the court for the Timberwolves as our 2nd quarter is underway. Russell in the backcourt with Beasley to his side. McDaniels is out there with Naz Reid. And it's Okogie in at the 3 spot. Smith with a wide open look. And a little luck that time, but it drops. Smith's got 6. Timberwolves leading by 18. Driving to the basket.
Exactly what you want from your point guard. Nice dime to the open teammate by Russell.
And we're starting the 2nd quarter, about a minute gone. And so it's Halliburton who brings up the ball for the Pacers. Hey, yo, get on Russell. Right side, Russell. Drains it from beyond the arc. Russell's got 19 points.
He's picking up right where he left off in the 1st quarter.
Knocks it loose. Teardrop shot, Taylor's shot, good.
How about that wonderful floater he has, showing off an exquisite touch.
Here's Beasley, and it's Beasley finishing it off.
Well, I tell you what, Beasley can really move. I mean, his drives are explosive and sudden. The defense has no way to stop him.
For Indiana, they've gone a nice 3-3 to start the second. Hustle with it. Halliburton picks him up. On up the court. Good for the basket. Number 9. He's only missed 2 shots from the floor all night.
Boy, he's been a rock of offensive support so far. And when they've needed a basket, they've turned to him.
Pass to Heald. Indiana again turning it over. Goga Bitadze is checked in for Smith. Vanderbilt's checked in for Minnesota. Torian Prince comes in for Josh Okogie. Here is Russell. He's got 21. And on our sideline, our reporter, David Aldridge.
Good evening, Kevin. Malcolm Brogdon has become a Pacers stalwart. He said, "I fit the identity of this team as an underdog that overperforms and proves people wrong. I've been asked to be the leader of this team. I lead with my voice and by example. I'll be fearless on the court so that my teammates can follow." Kevin?
I love what he's about, David. Thank you. Halliburton against Beasley. Over Halliburton. The rebound by Halliburton.
And he rushed that one, no doubt about it. The D out of position, you can see the frustration on his face.
Out of bounds. Minnesota takes possession.
And this has been a comedy of errors. I mean, you can just add another one to the list.
So it's both teams making substitutions here. And here are the Timberwolves. They're on an 11-2 run. And although he's a little undersized as a shooting guard, Beasley is still a great rebound.
First team foul.
And can regularly hit double-digit totals in that area. Very quick to the ball. Always nice to have a great rebounding guard.
Here's Russell. He had an 18-point outing in the last game against Chicago.
And not hard to see why they are giving up points on this run. Just too many good looks from in close.
He's guarded by Russell, and the Pacers can't get it to go.
There wasn't much defensive resistance there, guys, but somehow he blew it anyway. Missed opportunity.
Prince, that's for 2. That shot is off. And Indiana will go the other way with it. A nice shot by McDaniels.
There he is, beasting on the glass, converting the opportunity, trying to put this game away.
Well, he enjoyed it.
Oh.
Mercy, mercy me.
And guys, that's not as easy as he made it look. You've got to have some skills to pull that off.
Well, he's got plenty of those, yeah. That's for sure.
Yes, indeed. Let's just call him ladder climber.
Big miscommunication on defense. He recognizes it and quickly takes advantage.
Boy, the defense looks shell-shocked. I mean, they're on the ropes right now, on their heels.
Outside, Taylor. Inside, pocket 6. Count that one.
I mean, the number of points they've scored in the paint already here is eye-opening.
And Beasley, here we go. Good, and the assist goes to Russell. Russell's got his 7th assist of the game with that last one. For Indiana, they've gone 5-of-6 so far from the field in the second quarter. Back to Taylor. Oh, and the dunk by Taylor.
Now flying high and throwing it down with the one-hander.
Woo, one of his favorite moves right there, guys.
Does it as well as anybody, fellas. Tremendous skill while in the air.
The defense not putting up any fight on the inside. They've allowed 10 straight points in the paint.
That's not the kind of streak you want to be part of defensively. Tighten it up, fellas.
They recover it. And so it looks like the Pacers will retain possession here. Karl-Anthony Towns checked in for the Timberwolves.
Karl-Anthony Towns.
From the inbound, Duarte's shot good. Duarte's got 13 points.
Now how about how he sets his man up there, runs him right into the screen, and then gets the basket.
Prince's shot is good.
And now you see them starting to really work the ball inside.
Pacers have gone 7 for 10 here in the second quarter. They'd like to keep up that nice pace. He's guarded by Russell. Shoots from the elbow, and he sinks that one, hitting the back of the rim on the way in. He's got 5.
Wow, he was just wide open there. That's way too easy.
Here's Beasley. Good, and the assist goes to Russell.
Beasley.
For Indiana, they've gone 8 of 11 from the field in the second quarter. Really flowing here. There's the steal. Towns against Taylor. Shoots. That one off the back iron and out. Indiana's gone to three-point range 7 times tonight, knocked down 5 of them. At the teardrop, he takes it up and lays it in. And so it's Russell with it. He brings it up for the Minnesota Timberwolves. Following this one, they get to host the Hornets. That'll be the first of 4 played at home for him.
And not a great start for him in the first, but he's quickly starting to turn it around.
It's good from long range.
Not too much respect shown to him by the defenders.
From the wing, here's Towns. And easy 2 points on the layup.
One of the many skills that Towns brings every night is his offensive rebound.
Indiana's gone 6 of 8 on 3-pointers in the game, an outstanding 75% mark. To the paint. Here's Bitadze, and that one's good. His second basket of 4, shooting 50%.
And you know, passes like that go a long way. Terrific teamwork.
And it's Towns missing. And Indiana shooting an unbelievable 70%. You won't see a performance like this too often. From 11 feet away, a rebound by the Timberwolves. And the pass to Vanderbilt. And he makes no mistake on the slam dunk.
Towns doing a nice job with a smart play there, getting the ball to a ready shooter instead of trying to force it himself.
So it's the Pacers now. Down low. The shot is good. And so is his shooting tonight. 3 for 4.
Excellent assist there. Just led him to the perfect spot.
And Beasley, here we go. Taylor with the rebound. Pass to Duarte. And he bangs it home with one hand.
Really nice job moving the ball around that time, picking apart that defense.
Here's Beasley, and it's Beasley finishing it off.
Well, I tell you what, there's a little bounce to Beasley's game. This fella, he can get off the ground and elevate on you.
Duarte passes to Bitadze. Got a piece of it. And no good. Trying to use the glass. Minnesota's gone 1-2 on 3-pointers here in the second quarter so far. That's a 2 from Towns. And he makes that one.
Karl-Anthony
Towns has got 4 points now in the quarter.
Unwilling to let up even for a moment. That's his killer instinct. Just fanning the flame.
Yeah, I love the fact he doesn't play the score. He just keeps coming, attack mode. He doesn't know how to step off the gas pedal.
Here's Beasley. That's good. It's his 7th made basket in 14 tries.
Boy, he's really been on a roll this quarter. Seems like everything he throws up is finding bottom.
And the Pacers call time here. And Russell, a player known for his offense, but Greg, he's put in work to improve his play on defense as well.
Yeah, you know, Russell was known for his lack of defense there for a while. But he's been trying to improve that part of his game. It's a long road, but I tell you what, he is definitely taking steps.
Thompson, he's checked in for Goga Bitadze. Smith comes in for Brissett. Lance Stevenson subbed in for Taylor. Minnesota also making some changes. Okogie's checked in for Vanderbilt. Edwards comes in for Torian Prince. And it's Patrick Beverley in for Malik Beasley.
And just a perfectly designed play. Anytime you can get a dunk on the inbounds, you know the X's and O's were in the right spot.
Here's Duarte, 15 points in the game. Driving the lane, count it, and he's now 8 of 9 from the floor.
Just no resistance on the inside. That's their fifth consecutive make in the paint.
Those looks they're allowing are almost automatic.
Here's Edwards. Thompson with the rebound. Thompson's got 4 rebounds now tonight. Puts up a 3. And the Pacers another 3.
You know, if you're only looking at the way he's played offensively, you'd think his team would have the lead.
And the shot goes in.
Patrick Beverley.
Beverly's got 10 points.
Tremendous focus from the little man, Patrick Beverley, there.
2 minutes remaining in the first half. 2 minutes.
Stevenson outside. Fires the 3. It's hauled in by Edwards. And here's Edwards. He'll bring it up for the Timberwolves. Drives to the hoop.
Oh! Yes, sir! Come on, bring it! Fearless drive by Edwards, taking the ball right into the defense and finishing strong.
1:37 left in the first half of the game. Now Stevenson. Step back shot. Here's Thompson. First shot, first basket. He's on the blocks fast.
Pretty much all of their buckets coming from inside the paint now.
Russell looking it over. Up and in on the layup.
D'Angelo Russell.
Russell's got 29 in the game.
Well, I tell you, Russell looking very comfortable taking on aggressive defense and getting the job done. That's good focus on his part.
It's rebounded by Towns. Minnesota's gone 3-6 tonight when they've let it fly from downtown. Pulls it up. And he wills that one in. Sinking right through off the back iron.
And obviously his momentum from the last game has carried over here tonight.
I mean, you know, that's how it goes with him. I mean, his hot streaks, guys, don't last minutes. They last days.
Yep, that one goes in there.
The ball distribution was there. I mean, outstanding work all the way around.
Good, and it's Russell picking up the assist. He's got 15.
You know, so far he's been dominant this period, making the most of his opportunities.
3 seconds separate the shot clock and game clock. And he gets it to go as they call the foul. He's on his way to the line for one more.
That makes it 10 of their last 12 coming from inside the paint.
And this is his second trip to the line in the game.
And from the line, he's knocking it down about 71% of the time, and that's a percentage that needs to go up.
He's had trouble putting up the same numbers from the foul line that he put up last season.
Naz Reid, he's checked in for Karl-Anthony Towns. Indiana's gone 7 of 11 from deep tonight, using the three-pointer to their advantage. Here's Heald. Minnesota with the rebound. Reeves got 4 rebounds in this game. And out of bounds as the Pacers gain possession.
Now into the lineup for the Timberwolves, Jaden McDaniels.
And here are the Pacers now. Heald with it. From deep. And the last shot at the buzzer doesn't go in for him. And so it's Minnesota out there all by themselves with a 32-point lead to end the quarter. They've got a big advantage in the turnover stats because of their intense defense. And now let's catch up with David Aldridge, who's standing by from the sideline. All right, Dave.
Thanks, guys. Coach, where do you look to shore things up at the defensive end of the floor?
They're hitting us in some different areas. you know, so we got to give help on the inside. And with the guys we have playing tonight, we got to be real persistent, real together.
You got to find that chemistry very quickly. Thanks for your time. Back to you guys.
Thank you, David. And we'll be back after halftime as the third quarter gets underway.
The 2K Sports Halftime Show.
First half, it was all about D'Angelo Russell. He had 29 points, 6 steals, and a crazy number of assists. He didn't perform up to his standards in their last game. Tonight's a different story. He obviously has a short memory. And Kenny, what did you see out there from the Timberwolves?
All inside. Shaq, I know you like this. But the guys were sacrificing their bodies, making plays through contests, just wearing the hard hat. That's how this game's gotten out of hand so far.
And over to you, big fella. Your thoughts on the Pacers' first half.
It's their defense that's put them in this spot, giving up easy looks all over the place. It's like they don't have even a game plan in place. Check out the field goal percentage that they've allowed. Well, that's not going to cut it, Ernie. I don't even want to talk about it no more.
And there wasn't too much drama in the first half, but maybe things will tighten up here in the second. It's been a clinic out there with D'Angelo Russell.
Well, with the double-double in hand through two quarters, you can just imagine what his stat line will look like at the end of this one.
Yeah, he's got that locked-in look in his eyes tonight, and he's not going to start taking it easy. I think he's going to be going hard until that final whistle blows.
And as we dive into the second half, we'll find out if the next two quarters are any different from the first two. So far, it has been a runaway. They've got Tyrese Halliburton and it's Duarte in at the three slot. So that's who Rick Carlisle starts the second half with. And so it's Halliburton who brings up the ball for the Pacers. Takes a three, drops in the tray. 15 points in the game.
That's a textbook example of how to move the ball. Boy, you gotta love that action.
Towns dishes to Edwards. And Edwards with the stop.
Defense gets burned by Edwards' ball handling ability. I mean, this guy's athletic and can really move.
And Indiana shooting so well, the offensive execution has been brilliant. 66% from the field.
And it's a great move, and he catches the defense completely off guard.
Yeah, if that's a harbinger of things to come, he's looking at having a very big second half.
Here's Duarte, Edwards defending. Brissett passes Duarte. Halliburton against Russell. Five on the clock. Duarte, and it's Russell with the rebound. Timberwolves have gone 2 of 3 from the field to start the second half. Here's Beverly. Edwards trying to get open, one's good. Beverly's got 17.
They found a nice groove in this half, starting out 3 for 4.
Passes it to Brissett. Tipped away. It's in, and he's a very efficient 5 for 6 on the game.
And that assist got him a little nod from his teammate after that one.
The Timberwolves have gone 3 of 4 so far in the third quarter from the field. Pretty good start to the half. Here's Russell with a three. They grab their own miss. And it's Towns missing. Defended by Beverly. And here we go. Towns heading to the hoop. Here's Russell. Vanderbilt. He hangs in there and cashes in on the second chance points.
That is really good work there on the offensive glass.
A little under 2.5 minutes gone by here in the third. Now, here is Halliburton. He's got 6. Defended by Beverly. Stolen by Beverly.
Edwards drives in. And Edwards with the stuff.
Boy, you love to see Edwards shine on offense like this. I know it's got to be making his coach happy, too.
Third quarter here, and 3 minutes have come off the clock. The shot's good from Bitadze. He's got six.
Everything working for him out of the half as they've hit four of their first five shots.
Outside Edwards. Here's Towns. Score the basket. His eighth. 8 for 13 from the floor.
Well, that time Towns showing you that he has the physicality to beat the contact. The defense has to do a lot more than that to stop him.
Great D that time from Edwards. Timberwolves have gone 6 of 10 from the field in the third quarter.
And Anthony Edwards, the top pick of 2020. Not the most polished player early on, but his ceiling is through the roof. And he gives that rim a good tug on the way down.
Well, that's how you drive your point home right there.
He's lucky to get away with that, though, guys. I mean, it could have earned him a technical for hanging on too long.
Edwards, Anthony that's Edwards. Good. So many top picks come in ready to play, Greg. Edwards a part of a class that needed more time, though.
Yeah, the talent is clearly there. And don't forget the pandemic cutting the college careers of many of the 2020 draftees short.
Edwards,
though, has all the tools assisted to be an incredible wing player.
Beverly.
A one-man show offensively, and that's almost always good news for his team.
Has to be Johnson. Goes up high for the two-handed dunk.
Yeah, just solid work on the back end of that play.
Yep, you're right. Finished hard with two hands on that stuff.
Yeah, highly efficient. Nothing extra special there. Just effective.
And not the prototype power forward, but he has tremendous athletic ability.
They've been a little too casual with the ball out there.
Yeah, but you can't force that square peg into the round hole. Oftentimes, you just got to make that first simple pass and get a rhythm from that.
And the rejection by Towns.
Out of bounds.
And it's out of bounds. Last touch by Edwards. Prince is checked in for Vanderbilt. Minnesota calls timeout. And when Towns is on the floor, the attitude of this team, Clark, completely changes. They play with so much more confidence.
Yeah, I could not agree with you more, Kevin. He's a floor raiser. In other words, he makes everybody else play a little better and lifts up their confidence. And he does it while also putting up monster numbers of his own.
Beasley's checked in. And so here is Indiana. Duarte's shot good.
Duarte's
got 22.
Boy, you can see the connection these guys have. They ran the play well. The defense had no idea how to deal with it.
And keeping us updated from the sideline, let's swing it over to David Aldridge.
Thank you, Kevin. As NBA revenues climb into the tens of billions of dollars, teams have even more resources to compete. Staffs are growing, more coaches, trainers, and specialists, so general managers have more to manage than ever. Generally, the best organizations are those that effectively collaborate and communicate across the board. Kevin?
And DA, as we know, that's always been the case. Thank you. He throw good, Edwards.
The first overall pick of the 2020 draft, Anthony Edwards was one and done in college, entering the league at the ripe age of 19.
And so he hits both. Well, Greg, for those of us who have never played in the league,
What's it like traveling all over the country over the course of a long regular season?
Come on, Kevin. I bet you had a nice J back in the day. But seriously, it's a whirlwind tour. Sometimes you don't even know what city you wake up in. And I can tell you, there have been many times where I've gone back to the front desk complaining because my key didn't work, and only to find out I was using the wrong key. A slight rebound advantage for them. One more column in their favor, and it's all adding up.
Well, you take a look at all of the stats, the team stats, that is, and that's one of the many areas that they've had the advantage. And as a result, they've got a big lead.
Here's Towns. That shot is good. He's taken 15 and made 10 from the field tonight.
Love the unselfishness of Beverly. I mean, when he sees his teammate wide open, he quickly gets him the ball.
To the inside. The dunk and the foul, a powerhouse move, and he's got a chance for one more at the line. That one is on Towns.
Yeah, he earned that one. I mean, taking the hit and still able to get that one to go down.
Incredible, incredible body control right there. Don't know how he was able to get that one to go, but it sure was a thing of beauty to watch.
Minnesota's gotten fewer than half of their three-pointers to go down tonight. They're 4 for 9. Beverly, that's tipped, and that's out of bounds. Minnesota will retain possession.
Minnesota ball.
And now another look at that mobile one-block defensive performance.
Sharp instincts on D there. Just timing when to rise up and swat that one away.
Here's Towns, and that one drops. Towns has got 8 points in the quarter. And for the Pacers, they're shooting it as well as you're going to see, 67%. Towns with the steal. Whoops, anticipated the pass. Turnover. Halliburton right side. And he banks in the lane. Halliburton's got 10 points.
And that's got to happen if they want to have a chance to turn this thing around. I mean, he needs to just take the game over. I mean, it seems like he's been hesitant to pull the trigger.
And no help on that one. Towns, long strides, get all the way to the rack. Way to go, big fella.
Doesn't get it to drop for him. And Indiana will go the other way with it. Sykes, defended by Beverly. Halliburton outside. And again, it's the Pacers from deep.
Well, he's done his part. No doubt about it. Still yet to miss in the game.
And here's Beverly. He brings it up for the Timberwolves. Edwards drives in. Chalk up two there.
Anthony Edwards.
Edwards got 31.
Boy, he's demanding the ball. He wants it. And he's coming through. I mean, you can see why his teammates trust him down the stretch, guys.
And they get it back.
And you see Edwards trying to do this more, impose his will at the defensive end. Good job defensively that time.
And he drives in, and Edwards with the stuff.
And we always talk about making your teammate better. That assist was right on target.
Indiana's gone 2 of 2 from long range in the third quarter so far. Poked away. It's stolen by Edwards. And again, it's Minnesota. And taking a quick look here at the hustle stats for the Timberwolves.
You know, block shots, guys, a clear indicator on the stat sheet of their excellent defense. I mean, leaving them no room to get off any shots.
Yeah, and the other thing they've done since the beginning of this game is score points off turnovers and in bunches. You got to do more than that to keep the ball out of his hands down low.
Exactly. I mean, deny him the ball in the first place. Don't let him get it.
Friends trying to free himself up. Edwards, that's good.
They're doing a really good job of getting the ball inside and attacking the paint. That's an area they have completely dominated.
Well, once they recognized the advantage they had inside, it made a lot of sense just to continue to attack that area. It all started with the pass. That's what coaches love to see, ball movement.
Minnesota's gone 1 of 3 from downtown since halftime.
And it's good for
Anthony
two.
Edwards
got 39.
Well, the defense trying to throw Edwards off with some contact, but he smartly stays focused on his shot.
Sykes, it's tipped. Halliburton against Edwards. Whistle blows, bucket is good, and he'll have a chance at the line to make it a three-point play.
No, it's scary because he's just been a matchup nightmare in this game. He's eaten up anybody they've thrown at him.
The Timberwolves have made the most out of their opportunities at the line. They have yet to miss in seven attempts. Some changes for Minnesota. Naz Reid, he's checked in for Karl-Anthony Towns. McDaniels comes in for Torian Prince. And Okogie subbed in for Patrick Beverley. And taking care of the ball has been a problem for them.
That's something they've got to fix. While the defense has been good, a lot of these turnovers have been unforced.
Halliburton against Edwards. Down low, just five on the clock. Good!
That's serving it up on the platter there. What a nice pass. A high percentage look was the result.
The three. They get it back. McDaniels passes to Reed. Beasley for three. The Pacers pull it in. Heeled outside. The pass to Halliburton. To the middle. Here's Thompson. And it's Thompson with the jam.
Oh, Kevin, not a petty, not a manny, but a facial.
Oh, a bounce to the ounce, Greg? Yeah, showing off the bunnies.
He's a highlight reel. Always on the launch pad.
A minute 50 left to play here in the third. And here's Stevenson. Here's Jackson. Second shot opportunity, and it's good on the way in. Jackson's got his first points in this one.
Second chance points always hurt. Just not enough effort to block out.
Hey, guys standing around spectating. I mean, you got to get in there and get tough.
On the wing, Heald. He's got 12. Such a wide open look. Heald's got 14.
And I like seeing Heald take advantage of that mid-range area, appearing confident in taking that shot. Yeah, the defender all over
him. He got him good there. I mean, that's why the shot was so far off.
He's made all three of his free throws so far.
Anthony Edwards, two shots.
Take a break. Two shots.
And the first one at the line is good.
And not a single free throw attempt in that first half, but he has been far more active since the break and drawn some fouls.
And Indiana making a change here. Smith has checked in, and a change for the Timberwolves. Russell's checked in. And Edwards drops them both.
And if they continue, Kevin, their outstanding free throw shooting, that'll help them seal the deal.
Yeah, they've not missed a single foul shot this half. That's taking care of business, fellas.
Here's Smith. Oh, he blocked it and deflects off the backboard. And it's out of bounds. Last touch by Russell.
Indiana ball.
Here's Smith. 6 points for him. Here's Okogie. Lets it go from deep. The rebound by Heald. Halliburton in the corner. That one's good from the corner. Halliburton's got 11 here in this quarter alone.
And he's clearly led the way offensively. The question is, can they ride him and get back into it?
On the front foot, attacking the defense, this is Anthony Edwards at his best.
Indiana's gone 2-3 when they ventured outside the arc in the third quarter. The shot and game clock separated by four, and then Heal with the dunk.
And that's why you don't let him get positioned deep in the post.
Exactly. I mean, once he's got the ball in that area, the battle's already lost.
Yeah, he's shown terrific control of the pace and the rhythm of this offense.
You know, numbers don't always tell the story, guys, but his assist totals do paint the picture here. I mean, he's got everybody involved.
Nice work at the line so far, going 5 for 5.
Had a success rate from the line last year of about 78%.
Edwards against Heald. Pass to Thompson. Rebounded by the Timberwolves. McDaniel's got 4 rebounds now tonight. And so it's Minnesota sitting at a lead of 40 points at the end of the quarter. Terrific play. From the field, they have been outstanding. Amazing shooting. That's what has them headed to a blowout. And we've got more NBA action on 2K Sports coming your way after this break. And let's listen to head coach Rick Carlisle review the game plan with his guys.
Hey, it's all about who's more physical. And you got to meet them early in defensive possession. These guys are going to wear down, but we got to make them wear down.
Allen pouring his guys to up the aggressiveness on the defensive side.
And Kevin, preaching physicality. When you play for Coach Carlisle, you got to bring energy.
And we reach the fourth quarter in a game that may be already out of hand. Okay, now let's reset our lineups courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go for this fourth quarter. On the court for Minnesota, they've got McDaniels. Also, Naz Reid out there, and it's Okogie in at the three. And so it's Halliburton who brings up the ball for the Pacers. Pass to Stevenson. Let's it go with a three. That falls. Nice feed that time from Halliburton.
Stevenson. How can you forget about him? I mean, he's not going to miss that open of a look.
Here's Balmar. Another possession, another assist. And that's his 20th assist. Wow.
Just doing a great job at orchestrating the offense.
Now, here's Stevenson. Tight defense on him. Halliburton with it. He's picked up by Russell. Smith. That one, no good. So Minnesota will take it the other way. Here's Okogie. Here's Reed. That one falls.
It's never easy trying to keep him off the glass. He's an absolute beast down there.
For Indiana, they've gone 1 of 3 from the field to start the fourth quarter. Over to the left wing. Halliburton on the wing. He's guarded by Russell, and the three ball is good.
You know, he was a non-factor in that first half, but now he's making up for lost time.
Shot on the wing. Thompson with the rebound. Thompson's got rebound number 7 for him tonight.
You know, it's really surprising that they're up at this point, given that he's struggled so mightily.
Halliburton against Russell. From deep, Stevenson, and they'll get another chance. Here's Smith. It's deflected. Now, here's McDaniels, covered by Smith. The shot by McDaniels, no good.
And, guys, not sure where his head was on that shot. Not what this offense was designed to create.
Not at all. I mean, that's where they want him looking for a teammate, not trying to do it on his own. He needs to share the wealth there.
Wow, what a pass there. He made that a very easy basket with that setup.
The Timberwolves again can't hit. Halliburton against Russell. And he gets the whistle. Two free throws coming up.
And when Sacramento took Tyrese Halliburton 12th overall in the 2020 draft, they expected him to contribute right away. And Tyrese delivered with an NBA Rookie of the Month in his first 2 months in the league.
And he makes the first. Such a calming influence on the floor. Halliburton plays, Greg, way older than his age.
And remember, Halliburton spent 2 years in college. Most of the time we see one-and-done guys. But that second year can do wonders for your career. I stayed for the full 4 years, and that extra experience went a long way.
Halliburton hits them both. And, Greg, the league's in a great place for talent. So many incredible players just entering their primes. You excited where the league is right now headed?
Oh, my goodness, Kevin. Guys like Devin Booker, Luka Doncic, Donovan Mitchell. I mean, the list goes on. And a lot of these youngsters carrying their teams to great heights. Impressive to watch.
Pass to Perry. Back to Thompson. Not loose. Here's Noel. He's covered by Halliburton. Here's Lehman. Good. Nice job down low. Lehman's got his first basket.
How frustrating for the defense. You get the stop, but then fail to block out.
Well, you know, that's the way it's going to be for them today, fellas. Can't sustain any momentum.
A nice shot by Perry.
Oh, and look at how well he led him in there. Really, he passed him open for that deuce.
Two on none. No one back to stop this. Finished off the break.
Attacking in transition, the most consistent way to generate easy looks.
Yep, exactly. And if there's any opportunity for early offense, you've got to push it and push it every time.
And so it looks like the Timberwolves will retain possession here. Torian Prince, he's checked in for Minnesota.
For the Timberwolves.
Here's Noel. Offensive rebound. Stolen by Thompson. And up the court come the Pacers on the break.
Well, if you don't take care of the ball, fellas, that's what can happen.
Absolutely, Greg. That makes the turnover even more painful.
What? You mean the throwdown at the end? I'll tell you what, fellas. I mean, the highlight shows are going to pain them even more.
I love the ball movement there. He put that on a silver platter. Just served him up.
Driving inside. Laid in with a nice touch off the glass.
Oh, great ball movement there.
For Minnesota, they've gone only 6 of 14 from the field in the fourth. And the Timberwolves call timeout. In last season, All-Stars, Greg, missing 19% of their available games. With the shortened off seasons, are you concerned about the toll it takes?
You are, but this offseason maybe not as painfully short as the last one. And in these tough times, some sacrifices are made, no doubt. Health, perhaps, one of the biggest.
All right, look who's coming out of the court. Come on and get loud for your Pacemates. All right, look who's coming out of the court. Come on and get loud for your Pacemates.
Noel, not wasting any time and taking the shot and knocking it down.
Well, that's good work by Prince there, spotting the open man and then putting the ball on target on time right in the shooting pocket.
Harry, no good.
And he thought he had a clear path to the hoop, but the defense didn't give up on that play and cut him off.
Here's Reed, and he didn't get quite enough under that one.
You know, the fact is, he's not a lock from there, but he was open enough to where he should have hit that shot.
And Thompson gets it to go.
A super high percentage shot there. You just can't allow him to get that close.
Here's Lehman. Nice shot from the wing. Lehman's got 4 points this quarter.
That's a textbook example of how to move the ball. Boy, you gotta love that action.
And it is flushed down with a nice jam.
Textbook, nice pass, great catch, even better finish.
Minnesota calls timeout. Clark, you know, road teams accustomed to hostile crowds, but it can go too far. Players have been very vocal, saying, respect the game, and then respect us as human beings as well.
And, Kevin, I couldn't say it any better. It's that simple. It's not complicated. The right to say anything you want doesn't come with the purchase of a ticket. I think human dignity, common courtesy and respect supersedes whatever feelings you might have about a particular team or player and overrides whatever price you paid for your ticket.
Isaiah Jackson.
Minnesota shooting about 47% here in the fourth. Unloads. No good. Shot missing. So the Pacers will take it the other way. Got a hand on it.
Excellent toughness on the defensive end, and that's what Prince does. He's got size, and he's got the will to defend at a high level.
And out of bounds as the Pacers gain possession.
Indiana ball.
Indiana's gone 2-3 in the fourth quarter from long range. Good shooting so far. The pass to Jackson. Here's Perry, the 11-footer, it's good. Perry's got six in the quarter.
Oh, check out the handles. Their nasty spin move had his man grabbing for air.
Prince misses. Here's Indiana. They're on a 14-6 run. And it's blocked. Now Reed, pass to Noel. Here's Balmaro. Over Taylor. And too long on the shot. The Pacers shooting in the fourth has been tremendous, 59%. Out left to the wing, Sykes. Offline with his three. Timberwolves shooting a superb 63% from the field. Prince going inside. Count that one.
Well, it's clear Prince relishing being able to power through the defense there. Raw strength on display.
Oh, and the dunk by Taylor.
You have to love the unselfishness on display there. Excellent passing.
Minnesota with the ball. Ripped away. Pushing it up. Out to the right wing. Sykes makes no mistake on the open jump shot. That gives him a double-double in this one. 10 points and 11 assists. Here's Balmaro. They get it back. Reed. And the layup's good off the glass.
And they've gotten very aggressive on the offensive glass here in the second half, getting a lot of second chance points.
Passes to Taylor. There's the triple. And Lehman pulls it down.
It's a +5 advantage for them in rebounding after that one.
Let's it go from the wing. Here's Balmaro. Here's Reed. Tough break there, shot after shot. They couldn't get anything to fall. Pass to Perry. Some nice passing here by Indiana. And a beautiful feed leads to a monster jam.
My goodness, he is such a great dunker.
Craig, a high riser, no doubt about it.
Nothing surprising about that, guys. We've come to expect plays like that from him, and still, they never get old.
Controlling the defensive glass has been a problem here tonight.
Big difference in second chance points, and that makes it tough.
Indiana's gotten 3 of their 6 three-pointers to fall here in the fourth. Outside Jackson. And now that we've gotten a taste of it, Greg, what do you think of the play-in tournament?
I love it. I mean, it definitely has some pros and cons, and you want to keep as many teams as possible engaged down the stretch, but it's a long season, and for some teams, it just got a little bit longer.
And that one misses from Lehman.
Clearly, the defense could have been better there, guys, but he also needs to convert that.
There's the pass to Perry. Fades. It's in, and he's a very efficient 5-for-6 on the game.
Yeah, he recognized the overcommitment by the defense there and then made a smart pass to get that ball back outside.
Here's Balmaro.
2 minutes remaining.
No good on the three.
2 minutes.
He is single-handedly dropping the temperature in here with that cold streak.
And he's got to find other ways to contribute then, because his shot-making is not happening right now.
Here's Noel. Timberwolves with a fresh shot clock. The second chance effort. That one doesn't go, but he's still shooting 50%, 5 of 10. Sykes. It's good. The assist this time from Jackson.
Well, check out that assist. That's a pair of teammates that are clearly on the same page.
It's Prince on the wing. Over Taylor. Prince misses.
And, guys, not sure where his head was on that shot. Not what this offense was designed to create.
Not at all. I mean, that's where they want him looking for a teammate, not trying to do it on his own. He needs to share the wealth there.
They get the rebound. Taylor passes to Perry. Goes up again. A rebound by the Timberwolves.
It's really a tale of two quarters. Shot it so well in the last, but this one can't get anything to fall. And so it's going to end up in the record books as a blowout, a dominating performance for Minnesota.
You don't see this kind of a blowout often, but tonight this is a quality win across the board to deliver out this kind of punishment.
They definitely never changed the approach. They just kept after it and showed they were clearly the better team in just about every single category.
And so taking a look at their record, a nice milestone they'll be picking up tonight. 30 wins on the year now.
A 2-game season series. They win them both and complete the sweep.
That's a nice feeling to get the sweep, even though it is a small number. Still nice to get that sweep.
And when you look back at this one, what an amazing performance this was
for D'Angelo Russell.
Well, you have to marvel at how well he picked apart that defense repeatedly. Found the right guy in the right spot at the right time.
Present our New Balance Player of the Game, D'Angelo Russell.
And it's been a ridiculous performance in the best sense possible. I mean, everything about his game has been working. And no matter what they've thrown at him, he's had the answer.
Their previous two games have been losses, so something had to change to get them going again. And he provided that spark, giving them a huge jolt of energy. From the high post, misses off the left iron. He takes it in, and down it goes, jamming that one home.
Oh, how How about using the rim to get some true hang time?
You know, he just wanted to make sure the landing was softer than the takeoff.
Yeah, right. I don't know how much weight that carries.
The officials are all over that one.
Clearly a foul. I mean, didn't give him any choice but to blow the whistle. I mean, you got to play without fouling.
Shooting two.
That free throw missing. And that trip coming up empty, missing both. One thing we've seen from these guys is excellent passing.
No doubt about it. It's fun to watch the way they're operating as a team right now. They are all in sync.
Here's Noel. Prince with it. And again, unable to change momentum.
And they came in determined to take this one. It's going to be a happy flight home.
Yep, to have a stress-free win on the road, very satisfying. The fans are already headed for the exit.
So it's Minnesota winning this one easily. This one was over well before the final buzzer. The fans were waiting for something to get excited about, Greg, but they never got it.
They sure didn't. I mean, they just rolled to this win. They made it look really easy. What an efficient performance at both ends.
And a chance now to send it over to David Aldridge, standing by courtside. David.
Thank you, Kevin. Mike, it seemed like you were looking to push the pace at every opportunity. What was your mindset?
We're just trying to get out and run. You know, the less play calls, the better. So we're just trying to get out and run and find each other.
You did a great job in transition tonight. Thank you. Back to you, Kevin.
All right, David. Great job. Thanks so much. And that's going to do it tonight, folks, for our broadcast. For Greg Anthony, Clark Kellogg, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching. See you next time.